Yo, what's good, people? I got another Diamond Dynasty game for you right here. My opponent's pitching Noah Syndergaard, and I'm pitching Diamond Chris Archer that you get in the packs that you pre-order the game with. I was lucky enough to pull him. You know, I'm not a big fan of this card, to be honest with you. He gets rocked a lot with me. He either gets rocked or he'll pitch a complete game shutout. You know, he's fairly inconsistent with me. So this game, I decided to give him one more chance to stick in my rotation because I got other diamond pitchers that I'd rather use. But I'm giving this guy one last chance, and hopefully he doesn't disappoint me. So you see, first pitch of the game, my opponent rolls over to shortstop, which I got my my cat there. You know, one of my last videos, I say I hate cats with a passion. And there was this one game that I didn't record. It was a real good game that I ended up losing mainly because of a cap. And I said, you know, that's the final straw. I'm going to just make me a cap. That right there, that pitch right down the middle. That's not who I wanted it at. That's one thing I hate about Chris Archer. He misses his locations a lot. He drives me crazy. Now I got him on two strikes. You know, I'm trying to get him with the slider inside. And look, misses spots horribly. His Griffey, free base run. I'm up here thinking, oh, here goes Chris Archer. My main problem with him is him locating his pitches. And luckily, I was able to get a double play right after that mistake. So Chris Archer made up for it.
A speedy trade if you don't have outstanding control to go along with it. But he does.
Next inning, trash. Next inning, you know, I'm trying to fill out my opponent. What type of, you know, the first couple innings, you just filling out your opponent. What type of player he is. I swung at a bunch of pitches I shouldn't have been swinging at, you know. So I skip. You know, we get out there and not doing fairly nothing. This inning, I'm still filling out my opponent. He can't locate. Early in this game, he couldn't.
Chris Archer, he don't hit his location.
That's me talking during the gameplay. He misses his spots a lot, and that's how I felt in the beginning of this game. But once the game started going, so I got that confidence of his slider up. So I just kept using it. There you go. Missing his spots again. You can hear myself in the background. I'm just getting frustrated with him. I have no faith in Chris Archer in this game. But I'm starting to realize my opponent's a free swinger. So this is the time in the game I started. He was a free swinger. He just had no plate discipline. He was sitting fastballs, it seemed like, the whole game. So I just kept... He started to hit his spots with the slider, I think, in this inning. Then I realized... that one I missed a little bit, but luckily, right to my second baseman, which I got Trey Turner there. Man, right there, he was on that fastball, so I realized this guy got a kind of a quick bat. He was basically sitting fastball the whole game, so I got to keep throwing him. That's when I realized, you know, this inning, man, I'm just... swinging at him, hey. Bunch of bullshit. I'm still just trying to feel my opponent out, what type of player he is or whatever. And I just swung at a bunch of shit I shouldn't have swung at. Swing at a lot of bull. That's me in the gameplay talking. You hear me in the background. So I told myself, you know, I'm going to be patient this game. Right after that, horrible out. Started to be patient, worked a walk with my cat, and Paul Goldschmidt. In my opinion, he's one of the best first basemen in the game. I get a pitch I could drive right down the line. Easy double. So I got runners in scoring positions. Second and third, one away. Got Reggie Jackson. So it was I got two strikes right here. I'm trying to choke up and use circle. Yeah, I use circle when I got people in scoring position.
Man, I tapped circle.
I was frustrated because when you press circle, I tapped it and it made me swing. You know, it usually gives you the check swing, but you know. Next guy, Luke Coy, rolls over to second base and he got out the inning and I was hella mad.
No way in hell.
I get real mad when I play these games sometimes. But you know, that's baseball. So this inning, I'm starting to realize what type of type of hitter my opponent is. I realize this guy's not patient at all.
He's just sitting on.
You see me in the gameplay, just talking like, yeah, this guy got a fast bat. He's just sitting on a fastball. I'm just going to throw him junk until he can show me he can lay off of it. That was my mentality at this point in the game. Look at that, very early on
everything. Sitting on fastballs. I'm not giving him no.
And that perfect down and in to the lefty. He was just missing that. He couldn't touch that slider. That's a 99 break on that boy. On that Chris Archer slider. He got 99 break on that boy. So I just said, fuck it. I'm just going to throw a bunch of sliders. And I think that's why I was struggling with Chris Archer. I didn't throw enough sliders. That one was foul tip. I didn't throw enough sliders with him in my past starts. So I think that's the key with Chris Archer. Use his slider. So you got no Syndergaard. So far I struck out two. Let's try to strike out the side right now. Just throw him a fastball to keep him honest. Cause I just threw a bunch of sliders in a row. You gotta just mix a fastball in there. And we strike out the side, so right now we rolling, got no hits.
Take all away.
So yeah, I started to realize my opponent. I figured out my opponent wasn't giving me nothing to hit. He was just throwing me a bunch of junk. So I walked the four pitches with Trey Turner, and I said, "Fuck it, I'm stealing." You know for sure, goddamn right, I'm gonna steal. He ain't even holding me. Perfect jump. You ain't gonna throw Trey Turner out. You're not gonna throw him out. So I'm just sitting on something nice to drive. I get something where I wanted it, right up the middle. First score of the game. Break the deadlock. 1-0. Miguel Cabrera, the best hitters on my squad. You know, rolls over. You know Miguel Cabrera ain't gonna run out that easy double play. But at least we get one run.
He didn't throw me.
But I'm starting to figure out my opponent. You know, I'm feeling pretty confident now. See, I missed my spot with Archer. I think it's his fucking pitching motion. Like, I really do. It makes it real hard to hit his spots. So right now, I'm figuring out my opponent. You know, we rolling. Right now, I'm feeling real confident pitching to him now. Seeing him, you know, swung at a bunch of junk. Got a quick pop up. I'm thinking to myself, this guy got no patience and no type of discipline. This guy can't be a World Series player. Because I'm in the World Series. I'm just over 950 is my rating right now. I'm over 950. So this guy can't be World Series. But, you know, it's easy to get the World Series this year compared to last year. I was in Championship Series all year last year. But I'm fairly better at this game than I was last year. Mainly because the bunt cheese is gone. So we rip a hard liner down the line.
This is gonna be a single.
And like, yep, this is going to be a single. You hear me in the background saying this is going to be a single. Anybody under 60 speed ain't gonna turn that to a double, especially if it's hit that hard. So with my cap, I'm just sitting on anything good, and I got it.
That's out of there.
And like I said, caps are OP. I hate caps with a passion, but you gotta have them in this game to compete. You got to, and that's the sad truth. Hopefully they take them out next year. It's just not right, in my opinion. And here, Paul Goldschmidt, one of my favorite players. Like I said, best first baseman in this game. One of my favorite first basemen. Hanging curveball. He just kills it. He kills it. This is when we really started teeing off on Noah Syndergaard. He just hung that boy. I was just waiting on that boy. I just lined it up perfectly and just killed that bitch. Like it ain't shit. So I just swung at a bunch of junk. And we get lucky and beat that out for a hit. I ain't complaining. I'll take that. Now, I got Luke Corey back as my catcher.
That boy was crushed.
That was a very hard hit, boy.
almost at the warning track, dead center in Comerica Park. You know, they ain't going out. And I can't wait to put my cat back in catcher for that very reason. Because Lucroy, he just don't have enough power, like, to be effective. I'm going to put my cat. And I'm just sacrificing with Archer. I'm just trying to get this inning over with quick as possible, to be honest. I just want to go back to pitching with Trey or whatever. Not Trey, but fucking Chris. What the fuck I'm talking about. But yeah, I want to replace Lucroy, man. And put my cat back at catcher. You know, I had Francisco Lindor in my shortstop, but I sold him because of the coming market crash that might happen because of the season rewards. So, you know, I might buy him back at a cheaper price. And meanwhile, we got Ken Griffey hitting a triple down the line, or a triple, scoring two runs. So right this inning, we just lighting up Noah Syndergaard, just lighting him up right now. We just lighting up Noah Syndergaard. And we just got a comfortable lead. And I'm feeling at this point, ain't no way this guy gonna come back six runs. So right now I'm feeling hella confident. We got this game in the bag. And we got something to play for sure. Because we got a no-hitter going in the fifth inning. No hitter going to fifth inning, so I got something to play for. So I don't care what nobody say. Getting a no hitter online is an accomplishment, especially online rank. Now, granted, this guy has no plate discipline, but hey, I'm just dealing with Archer.
He's just carving him up.
Man, I can't remember. I mean, the last game I had this many strikeouts. Can't remember. Right there, I almost hung a changeup. Almost hung it. Could have got hit out the park. That shit I hate with a passion. When you try to pitch inside, I guarantee you that guy would have swung at that pitch. Another down and in slider for a strikeout. I'm just carving him up. Look at this guy. He wants to swing so bad. I don't know. Somebody teach this guy some discipline, like for reals. Teach this guy some discipline. Jesus Christ. So impatient, though. Look at that. Very early. You see how many sliders I threw in a row? And when you finally throw him a fastball, he's slightly on it. So this guy was just sitting a fastball the whole game. And look, we got 14 in a row set down. Fifth inning, no hit still. So I just skipped the next inning because right now we chasing history. We chasing history right now. We just going to show from this out, point out, all Chris Archer.
Look at that. Then one of them pitches, he just couldn't lay off. Look at how much break.
That one was close. He almost hit that down the line. And I was like, you know what? You just throw him one fastball. That was too high. That was way too high. Not enough for him to offer. Oh my God. Like I said, that bails out the hitter. I guarantee you he would have swung at that if that damn animation didn't happen. You perfectly locate and you tag Posada for the out. Two down, six inning with the pitcher coming up. And he puts in Freddie Freeman, so I'm thinking like, oh shit, let's not get him out. I got him to one strike. He rolls over. Thank goodness for the shift. No hitter through six innings, man. No hitter through six innings. Again, close. So, fast forward, two outs. Six inning, two outs. I'm going for this Griffey mission. All I need is a home run.
Oh my God, that was my pitch.
That was my pitch right there. I could have done something with. All I need is a home run to have a chance at this Griffey mission. So that's why I'm showing this clip. And can we get it? Ooh. Look at that. I power swung that. I was just under it. And can we? This ball is deep. Come on, get out of there.
Get out of there. Get out of there.
Oh, in the deepest.
Oh, my God.
If I didn't have any park, if I had any park other than Comerica, that would have been a home run. So I kind of screwed myself with that, trying to get this damn Griffey mission. This guy has no discipline. I'm just throwing the slider right down the middle. That ball, he should have crushed if he was sitting on. Now I throw an inside fastball. He was super late on that. Barely touched that down the way sink. I mean, not sinker, down the way slider. Barely touched it. He just looking horrible at the plate. Somebody get this guy some glasses, man. He cannot see the ball at all. At this point, his confidence is sky high. Like, me throwing fastballs is dangerous. I don't even know why I'm throwing fastballs against this guy when he showed no ability at all to hit the off speed and break his stuff. So, I ain't trying to get. But I feel like during this game, I got to throw him an occasional fastball to keep him honest. I don't want him to sit slider the whole game. And I throw a slider next pitch and have him roll over. And we out the inning. So, we got a no-hitter through seven. Six more outs, baby. Six more outs. So we fast forward to the eighth inning. Trying to get this high fastball, but he keep missing too high. Let me do it one more time. Hopefully, I gave up bombs throwing high fastballs out the zone. So I would, that was a dangerous pitch. Right there. Dangerous pitch. So I got him on one strike count. That down and in slider been working against the lefties all game. Went right back to it. Went back to another down slider. He just has no discipline. You get another strikeout with Chris Archer. He just having a phenomenal game. You got the cap. You got five more outs, baby. Five more outs for this, for history. It's basically a perfect game, but I don't think the hit batter counts as a perfect game. So we go to shortstop. You got 97 speed.
Oh my God.
Ooh, that was close.
That was so close. That was so close. You see me in the gameplay.
That almost fucked my perfect game up.
That almost fucked up everything. Thank goodness for that 91 arm strength, because that was Francisco Lindor. He would have for sure been safe. At 91 arm strength on my cap, OP. Ooh, so I'm in a dangerous spot. Like, for some reason, he's starting to miss his spots. I'm trying to get this no-hitter, baby. Ooh. He's just hitting them fastballs hella hard. So we got three more outs. Three more outs. We skip the next half inning. I score an extra run, but that don't matter. We trying to get this fucking no-hitter. We trying to get this no-hitter. We only three outs away from history. For some reason, he's missing his spots. Throw a fastball right down the middle. Oh,
my
God.
God.
And it's gone. Oh, my goodness. And there he goes.
God damn it.
We did one thing that we said we wasn't going to do, and that was throw a fastball. And it was out the zone, and he crushed it for a home run. So the no-no is over, but still, Chris Archer pitched a phenomenal game. Phenomenal game. He gave up the no-no. He pitched a phenomenal game. I am disappointed that I didn't get that perfect game, and we strike out the next guy. We got one out. Still, can we get the complete game? A complete game with him. I guess he started to get tired at this point because he was missing his. He was pitching like regular Chris Archer that I'm used to, and he just hangs a changeup, and this ball doesn't. You don't even see where the ball lands. You don't even see where the ball lands. He just absolutely murdered that ball. I think that was almost 500 feet. That home run. So Chris Archer choked under pressure in the ninth inning to get this perfect game.
Come on, man. Now all of a sudden you can't locate.
He just choked. It was too much pressure. But still, it's all about the win. You get down
got two more down. Let's end this with a strikeout. And it's a high. There goes the last out of the game. Excuse me for my burping. But Chris Archer just pitched a wonderful game. So maybe I just should throw more sliders with him, because the slider is fucking filthy. 11 strikeouts. Great game. So yeah, I just wanted to show y'all this video. I almost had a no-hitter, but it didn't work out for me. So yeah. Anyway, stay tuned for my next video. I'll see you guys. Peace out.